या सर्वलेट फिल्टर्स गाइस। दिस इज पार्ट ऑफ सर्वलेट एपीआई। सर्वलेट फिल्टर्स आर पार्ट ऑफ सर्वलेट एपीआई, पार्ट ऑफ सर्वलेट एपीआई। नाइस। नाउ टेल मी गाइस, सर्वलेट फिल्टर्स आर स्पेशल वेब कंपोनेंट्स ऑफ जावा वेब एप्लीकेशन दैट आर कैपेबल ऑफ ट्रैपिंग ईदर ऑल रिक्वेस्ट एंड रेस्पॉन्सेस, ईदर ऑल रिक्वेस्ट आर मल्टीपल रिक्वेस्ट एंड ऑल रेस्पॉन्सेस आर मल्टीपल रेस्पॉन्सेस टू अप्लाई कॉमन एंड ऑप्शनल सर्विसेस, कॉमन एंड ऑप्शनल सर्विसेस ऑन रिक्वेस्ट एंड रेस्पॉन्सेस, ऑन रिक्वेस्ट एंड रेस्पॉन्सेस विदाउट टचिंग सोर्स कोड ऑफ द एग्जिस्टिंग वेब कॉम्पोनेंट्स। I don't want to touch the source code of existing web component, but I want to add additional and common, additional, common and optional services to the request and response. Then we have to take the support of what? Sarlet filters. Got it? Okay. Now listen. In hurry burry, I released the website. I noticed in certain browser, Microsoft Edge, it is not working properly. It is not working properly. So what should I do? Without touching the source code of existing web application, okay, I should block the request coming from Microsoft Edge. I should guide them. Don't use Microsoft Edge. Try to use other browsers. So whenever request from Microsoft Edge, that should be trapped, that should be blocked, and for them message should be generated. Don't give request from Microsoft Edge. That too without touching the source code of existing web components. Then we have to take the support of what? Sarlet filters are not. Okay. Sarlet filters are special web components of Java web application that are capable of trapping either all requests or multiple all requests and responses or multiple requests and responses to apply the common, additional and optional services, optional additional services without disturbing the other web components of the web application, the other web components of the web application, without disturbing the other web components of the web application. Everyone getting my point, guys? Come on. Without simply not disturbing other web components of the web application, guys. Okay. So it looks like this, guys. This is my browser. This is my web application. Java web application, boss. Java web application. Here is my browser window. Done. Okay. As I said, when these special classes will be there, guys? Sarlet filters, how many? Filters and wrappers, how many days I will talk? Okay. Sarlet filters and wrappers. Wrappers, what are the timings I will talk, guys? 3 days. Today at 10:45. That's the session one. Come on. Okay. Next Saturday. Next Saturday 4 p.m. session 2. Next Sunday 10:45 a.m. That is session 3. This is the plan, guys. Sarlet filters and wrappers will be discussed. Clear, my dears? Right. This is my Java application, boss. Here are my, this is my Sarlet filter. This is my Sarlet filter. Okay, guys. Yeah, here are other web components of the web application. Other web components of the web application. Yeah. Servlet 1 / JSP 1. Copy. Servlet 2 / JSP 2. Servlet 3 / JSP 3. Okay, guys. Sarlet 3 / JSP 3. Actually, we give request to what, guys? We originally give request to Sarlet component only, which originally wants to get the response from what? Sarlet component only. Originally give request to Sarlet component. We originally wants to get response from Sarlet component. This is my request, guys. This is my response, guys. Okay. This will be trapped, guys. Again, it will be trapped, guys. Request will be trapped and response will be trapped. That's a basic work of what filter was. This is number one. Okay. Who traps the request? Filters up traps the request and delegates to appropriate web component. There, normal logic executes. Number four. Generates the response. And generates a response, traps the response, applies post by trapping request, pre-processing logics. By trapping response, post-response generation logics will be applied. And finally, response goes to browser. Tell me, guys, number two, Sarlet filter trapping the request and applying pre-request processing logics. Number six, Sarlet filter component trapping the response and applying post response generation logics. What logics, guys? Post response generation logics. Traps the response and applies what? Okay, applies. That's a better wording. Applies. Okay, post-response generation logics. Right, guys? Okay, always use filters to apply additional, common, and optional pre-request processing logics. And post response generation logics by trapping the request and responses by tagging the request and responses. Right, boss. Now listen, three types of filters are there. Three types of filters. Number one, request filters. Number two, response filters. Number three, request-response filters. Number three, request-response filters, guys. Okay, request filters contains only pre-request processing logics. What logics, guys? Pre-request processing logics. Tell me. Examples. Authentication filter. Before getting into application, it will verify the user. Authorization filter. Before getting into application, it will check access permissions of the user. What, guys? Access permissions of the user. Understanding my statement, guys. Authentication filter, authorization filter. Request dumper filter. Dump every information of the request. Dump every request. Dump every information of the request, guys. Request dumper filter. Okay. Browser checking filter. If browser is not Chrome, reject it. Initial days of Chrome, if you open Google or Gmail other than Chrome browser, they used to threaten you. All features may not work. Try to install Chrome. How they are checking the browser? Like this only. Browser checking filter. Come on. Okay. Next one. Time checking filter. Trading website is there. They allow trading in between 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. only. Trading checking filter, guys. Trading filter. Next, double posting problem. Double posting problem. Preventing filter. And etc. Many things you can take, guys. Next, what we got? Response filters. Okay. Response filters contains only post response generation logics. Post response generation logics. Examples, guys. Examples. Image conversion filter. Image conversion filter. Image format conversion. Website is giving images in JPEG. You know, I want some other format. Okay. Next. What is that? Locale change filter. Website is giving output in English style of US. No, I want to get in some other language, right? Locale change filter. Okay. Supporting internationalization, guys. I18N. The word internationalization is having 20 letters. In shortcut, we can say I18N. Supporting internationalization. Okay. Okay. Signature. Signature adding filter. Signature adding filter. At the end of the every response, I want to add some signature. I want to add some signature and etc. Okay. Modifying the receiving response, Ra Babu. Modifying the receiving response. Changing the receiving response. Request-response filter. Contains both pre-request processing and post-response generation logics. Example, performance test filter. Example, what guys? Performance test filter. Traps request gets start time. Okay, traps response gets end time. The difference between end time and start time. End time and start time will be used to evaluate performance of the filter. To evaluate performance of the filter. Okay, guys. Rama, please join on time now, boss. Without touching the source code of existing web component, if you want to add additional logics, then we can take the support of filters. Rama, keep the good habit of attending class on time, right, dirty fellow? First, attend class on time. What I said, additional optional services without disturbing other web components of the web application. Is this point registered in your brain? At the time of development, initial development, I don't have. Later, I want to add. And moreover, what is the other point I have given? Always use filter to apply additional, common, optional pre-request processing logic and post-response generation logics by trapping request and responses, right? Optional. Sometimes I want to enable, sometimes I want to disable, right? Initially my website is not ready for Edge browser, Microsoft Edge browser. Later I made it ready. Until I make my website ready for Edge browser, any request from Edge browser should be removed or not. Next, trading is allowed 9 a.m. to 5 p.m. Now after a few days, they decided to allow 24 hours trading. So that time in filter only, we have to check the time now. In the filter only, we have to check the time. Got the point there? Performance test filter, guys. Now listen. Yeah, a filter, servlet filter, filter or filters can be mapped with one or more web components of web application. Every filter must be configured. Linking with other web component or component. Okay, either using filter mapping tags. What is this? XML driven configuration. Or using @ web filter annotation. Annotation. Where in annotation driven configuration. Yeah, if you don't know annotation, don't worry. Very soon we are going to study about them. Okay. @ web filter annotation. Very simple, guys. Instead of writing configuration details in web.xml, on the top of the classes itself, we can use annotation to configure the Java class as servlet @ web servlet, to configure Java class as filter @ web filter. That is @ web filter. Is that clear, guys? Come on. Done, boss. Okay. Like at the rate override is only giving guidance, but this is for configuration. This is alternate to XML entries, web.xml entries, guys. Okay. Every filter must implement. Okay. javax.servlet.filterinterface. Okay. Or jakarta.servlet. In recent version, JavaX is replaced with Jakarta. You know that. Jakarta.servlet.filterinterface directly or indirectly. Filter interface directly or indirectly. Either directly or indirectly, it has to implement that interface. Okay. This interface contains three default methods. Are Java 8 interface, guys. Three default methods as lifecycle methods. I think three or two now. 1 minute. I think two only, because one is the one they have made it mandatory. Servlet 4 filter interface docs. Okay, servlet interface docs. I'm looking for documentation now, boss. This is which version? Java E6. Look at the methods. Void destroyed. Array, these are old methods only, boss. These are old methods. 1 minute. Let me collect from Java E7. Filter interface. Yeah, Java E7, guys. They are not giving any default methods, huh? No, servlet API, since servlet API. What is this? Java E8 I will take. Wait. This is what I'm trying to say. When you believe something, don't give up. Default. Do filter is not default. Understanding my point. Having two default methods. And one abstract method. As filter lifecycle methods. Yeah, filter lifecycle methods, guys. What they are, guys? Public void init. Filter config. Array, how servlet config is there? Filter config also there. Filter config throws servlet exception only. for filters, instantiation event. For filters, instantiation event. Next, we are having do filter request, comma, response. Then one more object, filter chain chain. Throw servlet exception, comma, IO exception. For filters, request processing event. For when filter traps a request, comma, response. When filter traps a request, comma, response. Lastly, guys, public void destroy method. When filters, destruction event rises. Guys. Okay. Yeah, like servlet lifecycle method, we are having this one, guys. Filter config object is the right hand object to filter class object. This is my filter class object. This is my filter config object. FC. Yes. How servlet config object is useful to gather more information about servlet? Okay, similarly, using filter config object, we can gather more information about filter. Okay, guys. Now listen. Okay, filter servlet filter API from Java EE8, guys. It is coming from Java EE8, latest versions, guys. Latest one. We have got javax.servlet.filter interface. Okay, this javax can be replaced with Jakarta. Extending from that, we have a generic filter, guys. javax.servlet.genericfilter class. That is abstract class, guys. In the place of Java. Tell me here, what is this HTTP filter, guys? What filters, my dear? HTTP filter is. Got the point, guys? Extends. Okay, here, this is the default method, guys. This is also default. Only do filter method is not default. Okay, Same like Sarlet only will be there. Inspired from Sarlet only, guys. Inspired from Sarlet only. Got it? Seriously, inspired from Sarlet only. Okay, now you have a freedom, guys. We have a freedom. We can develop filter in three ways. Okay, you want to check that? Generic filter, guys. Generic filter, abstract class. And HTTP filter, guys. Okay, HTTP filter. Yes, we are having HTTP filter. Okay, this is also an abstract class. Okay, in HTTP filter, we have a two do filter methods are there. Remaining all are inherited methods only. Remaining all are inherited method. You look at generic filter, guys. Init and extra init method has come. Extra init method has come. Did you notice that? Extra init method has come. Extra init method has come. Filter config is implemented there. HTTP filter. Okay. Contains what, guys? Contains additional init method. That is init with no parameter. Additional init method, init with no parameter. Okay. Contains two do filter methods. Two do filter method. What is this? Public wide do filter. Public wide do filter. Sarlet request req. Sarlet response res. Throws sarlet exception comma event. HTTP sarlet request. HTTP sarlet. Throws a sarlet exception comma this one. Okay, filter chain is missing. Okay, all these are having one more parameter called filter chain. Filter chain, filter chain. Filter chain, filter chain. Okay, guys. Right. Array, filter chain object. Filter chain object holds. Okay, holds the destination web component info. Okay. If the filter is the last filter in the chain. Filter chain object hold destination web component info. If the filter is last filter in the chain. Otherwise, filter chain object which filter component holds next filter info. Next filter info. Next info are details, guys. Info are details. For example, come on. Info or details. For example, come on, guys. For example, this is browser. Filter 1, filter 2, filter 3. This is Sarlet component. browser. Filter one here, filter two here, filter three here. Here is my satellite component. Okay, guys, listen. Filter chain object of filter one. Filter chain object of filter one holds filter two detail, filter two info. Filter chain object of filter 2 holds filter 3 info. Filter chain object of filter 3 holds destination servlet component info. The destination servlet confirm, like linked list kind of thing, guys. Linked list again. While trapping response, it will be reverse, you know that. Okay, in which order requests are trapped, in the reverse order response will be trapped, you know that, right? Here is my request, guys. Here is my response. Okay. If multiple filters are trapping the request, okay, trapping request in a chain, in which order they are trapping request. In which order they are trapping request exactly in the reverse order they trap the response. Exactly in the reverse order they trap the response. Array, while going, if it is 1, 2, 3, 4, while coming out, it is definitely 4, 3, 2, 1, guys, kind of thing only, na boss. While coming out, it is going to be 4, 3, 2, 1, 1 kind of thing. What do you say? Understanding my statement here, guys? While coming out, it is going to be exactly reverse. Okay. Exactly in reverse order, they trap the response, guys. Okay, guys. Now listen. Sample filter code, guys. Now listen. Public class filter one extends from generic filter, extends from generic filter or HTTP filter or implements from filter interface. Either that or this, guys. implements from filter interface. Everyone getting my point? Come on, guys. Or implements from filter interface. Okay, public void init. Here initialize array, second init method is there or not? Okay, you can direct, if you want, you can override directly. Filter config cz. Initialization logic. Public void do filter. Okay, servlet request req, servlet response res, throws servlet exception comma io exception, throws servlet exception comma io exception. Here third parameter is there in do filter, guys. What is that? Filter chain object. Yes, chain dot do filter request comma response. This is post logic, guys. This is pre logic, pre request processing logic. Whatever logic you kept, that will execute. That whatever logic you kept before chain dot do filter, pre-request processing logic, guys. Next, this is called post response generation logic. What is this post response generation logic? Okay, next one. Because of this, next filter in the chain or destination web component will be invoked. Destination web component will be invoked. Okay, see, in one place only we are writing both, na boss. These are pre-logic, these are post-logic. Array filter traps a request, can execute both pre-request processing and post-response generation logic. Are you able to feel it? Yes, boss. Next, destroy uninitialization logics. Uninitialization logic. End of the class. Everyone got the clarity? So main thing is what, guys? Do filter. Main thing is what? Do filter. Sorry, don't you become it recursive call? No, it's a do filter with a three param. It's a do filter with two params. Both are different. Both are, it's not going to become recursive call. So chain object holds next filter or destination web component info. That's why when I say chain dot do filter, when I say chain dot do filter, come on. Okay, it will passes the control to next filter in the chain or destination web component or to the destination web component. Understanding my point, guys? Super boss. Okay. To map one filter with one servlet component, with one servlet component, what should I do? Okay. Actually, we can map one or more filters with one or more web components, guys. One or more filters components can be mapped with one or more web components. To map one filter with one servlet component. Servlet component URL pattern. servlet component URL pattern. Come on, guys. Slash test one. Okay, servlet one component URL pattern. Filter one component URL pattern. Slash test one. Same thing you have to take, guys. Okay, same thing you have to take. To map. To map two filter components with one servlet component. One servlet component. Servlet one component URL pattern. Servlet one component URL pattern. Test one. Okay. Filter one component URL pattern. Test one. Filter two component URL pattern. Test one. Again, test one. Because the array, it won't have its own request. Always takes the others request. Always take the others request. So that's why others URL pattern, you have to take filter URL pattern. To map one filter with, okay, two servlet components or multiple servlet components. Servlet one URL pattern. Try to have some commonality. Slash test one ABC. Servlet two URL pattern. Slash test one XYZ. Filter one URL pattern. Slash test one star. Understanding my statement, guys? Okay. Array, if having same URL pattern, servlet and filter is there, first filter gets the priority to execute. Then servlet gets the execution. That will be taken care by container. Container gives first priority to filter, then priority to servlet. Okay, boss. Next. To map two filters with, okay, two different filters with different servlet component. Different servlet component. Servlet one URL pattern slash test one ABC. Servlet two URL pattern slash test two ABC. Next. Servlet 3 URL pattern, servlet 4 URL pattern, slash test 2, slash test 2, ABC XYZ. Tell me. Filter 1 URL pattern, slash test 1 star, maps with servlet 1, comma servlet. Filter to URL pattern. Okay. Maps with servlet 3 and servlet 4. Like this, you have to create something that matches the patterns. Okay, guys. I think you got the idea how to handle the situation. Different filters with different servlets. Okay. To map filter with one filter with all web components. One filter with all web components. Use the URL pattern. use the URL pattern slash star. Use the URL pattern slash star. If you use URL pattern star star for filter, it will trap all requests and all responses of all the web components. Okay, filter traps requests and responses of response of all requests. Filter traps all requests and responses of all requests and responses of all the web components. All the web component. Yeah, slash star. Oh, yeah, I have given reverse a slash star. That's a special URL pattern, guys. Okay, now listen, guys. Once the servlet container only creates our filter class object either during server startup and or during deployment of the web application. Either during server startup or during deployment of web application. No load on startup is required. Naturally, it is having load on startup, guys. Are you with me? No load on startup is required. For servlet to bring this effect, we need to go for load on startup. No load on startup is required. Naturally, its object will be created during server startup. Before servlet, only servlet filter will be there. The servlet container destroys our servlet class object. What, guys? Our servlet filter class object or filter class object. When the web application is stopped or undeployed or reloaded or server started. Server crashed or stopped. Understanding my statement, guys? Okay. Automatically, we don't create filter class object. It won't be even created for first request. They will be instantiated the moment application is deployed or server is started up, guys. That means filters are very much ready before servlets. So that's why having same URL pattern when request comes, instead of going to servlet JSP, it goes to filter because filter is also having same URL pattern of servlet. Servlet object instantiation happens bit lately, but filter object instantiation happens very fastly. That's why filter traps a request and passes to appropriate web component. Come on. So I'm talking about when servlet container creates our filter class object, when servlet container destroys our filter class object. Yes. Okay, this is introduction, guys. Okay, now listen, guys. There is no separate filter context object. there is no separate filter context object, but we can use servlet context object. We can get access to servlet context object by using filter config object. Hari, there is no filter context object. Don't create your own terminologies. No, okay. There is no such a terminology. But we can access servlet context object by using filter config object. Anyhow, filter config object is visible in the init method level, also visible at class level. You can use any filter config object case. Both are same. Are you comfortable, my dears? Guys, are you comfortable up to this? I hope you understood basics of the filters. I hope you got basic fundamentals about filters, guys. Yeah, tell me, let me ask one question. Filters are used to apply mandatory services on application or optional services? Optional services. Once filter services are developed, they will be applied forever or on temporary basis? They will not be applied forever. They will be applied on what? Temporary basis, right? Now tell me, do I need to enable load on startup to get the filter class object during server startup? Is that clear, guys? Come on. We don't need, right? Tell me, what are the filter lifecycle methods? Filter lifecycle methods, guys. Filter lifecycle method. Init, do filter, and destroy method. Destroy method. Okay. Destroy method. Now tell me, how many approaches are there to develop the filter? Only one approach or three approaches? Three approaches are there. By implementing filter interface, by extending from generic filter, by extending from HTTP filter. What is the best approach, guys? Extending from HTTP filter is the best approach or not? Extending from HTTP filter is the best approach. Okay. Definitely extending from HTTP filter is the best approach. Right, boss. How many types of filters are there? How many types of filters are there? Three. What are those? Request filter, response filter, request and response filter, right? Now tell me, can we use filters to add extra functionalities to web application without touching the source code of the web application? Yes. Possible or not possible? Okay. I want to see one filter trapping request and response of all the web components of web application. Then filter should have which URL pattern? Slash star. I want to map one filter with one servlet. Then what should I do? I should map one filter with one servlet. What should I do? Servlet URL pattern you should take as a filter URL pattern. What filter chain object holds? What filter chain object holds? If next filter is there in the chain, it holds next filter object details. If next filter is not there, destination web component is the final one. Then it holds final web component details. The final destination web component details. Everyone got it? Okay, boss. Sir, how filter differentiate pre-request processing logic and post-response generation logic? How filter differentiate pre-request processing logic and post-response generation logic? Pre-request processing logic and post-response generation logic. Based on what? Based on what? In do filter method overriding, the logic written before chain dot before do filter method call is going to be pre-request processing logic. The logic you write after chain dot do filter method call is going to be post-response generation logic. Post-response generation logic. Thank you guys. Have a nice time. We'll meet on next weekend for continuation of this topic. Tomorrow you have a regular class, your regular timings. But 1 minute, please wait for a minute. There are some videos that we have to watch, guys, in this entire week. YouTube.com Naresh IT. YouTube.com Naresh IT. Now tell me here, what is this? Okay. What is the point I should go for? Dynamic resistation of servlet. Dynamic servlet resistation. Dynamic servlet resistation, guys.
This sentence is grammatically correct. Wordy and hard to read.
Dynamic servlet resistation. Already given to you people, huh? Okay, if you have not done, already taken, take it.
Installation is simple and
next.
Visit grammarly.com today.
Okay, next one. Servlet URL pattern. Three videos are there on this topic. Use them. Servlet URL pattern. Okay, I'll give the link, don't worry. Servlet URL patterns. Okay. servlet URL here is what video.
My name is Natras. In this video, I'm going to talk about what is URL pattern and different types of URL pattern that can be used in servlet programming. First, let us try to understand what is URL pattern.
That's the first one, guys. This is the second one. I'll share with you, don't worry. This is the third one, guys. Save this.
Hi friends, my name is Natras. In this video, I'm going to talk about some miscellaneous discussions related to URL patterns.
Done. Servlet URL patterns. Everyone got that? And one more thing, dynamic registration of servlet. Dynamic registration of servlet. Yes, this video, guys. This video. Please save them. In 1 week, you have to complete this video watching. Okay, in 1 week you have to complete this video watching. Then Java Bean videos. Yeah, small videos, don't think much. Java Bean videos. All these are small videos, guys. Don't worry. Thank you, guys. Have a nice time.